Welcome to this 26th lecture. In this we will see quadratic or second order elements. As I mentioned earlier, linear elements may not be good if the field is varying drastically in some regions, and if you do not want to use very fine mesh of linear elements, then you can use fewer elements of or coarser mesh of higher order elements to get the same accuracy, right. So to start with, we will just refresh. For linear triangular element, we had seen this expression for B, Bx and By were this, is it not? Daba Az by Daba Y was this, Daba Az by Daba X was this in one of the earlier, in fact lecture 21, this formula was there. And then we also saw that these are just constants, because A1, A2, A3 are the values that you would have got after the FEM solution, and Q1, Q2, Q3 and P1, P2, P3 are just they depend on only the coordinates of the vertices, is it not? So that means Bx and By are constant over element, which may not be true in highly non-uniform fields. Right, so errors will be appreciable. So then we can go for second order or quadratic formulation. Now, quadratic triangular elements, the corresponding approximation is this. Again, now see, these are the six nodes. Now the three nodes are as usual 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are at the centers of three sides. Okay. Now there are 6 nodes, so there should be 6 unknowns A, B to F, and the corresponding approximation, one of the approximation you can have is this A plus Bx plus Cy Dx square plus Exy plus Fy square. This is a logical approximation that you will make with 6 constants, is it not? And then you can actually, using the same procedure that we followed for linear triangular element, what did we do? There, using that phi expression there, we expressed phi 1, phi 2, phi 3, and then we eliminated ABC by taking inverse, is it not? And by eliminating ABC, finally we got this expression with I goes from J 1 to 3, is it not? So here same thing you can do, but now here you'll have to invert 6 by 6 matrix to eliminate these constants A to F, is it not? You will have to invert 6 by 6 matrix, which is you can see the computational burden is becoming higher. So that is why there is a simpler method called as area coordinates approach, which we will see, which does not require you to invert, right. So what is that approach? Area coordinate system, it uses area coordinates or natural coordinates as they are defined. So for example, they are L1, L2, L3. What is L1? It is delta 1 by delta, delta 2 by delta, and L3 is delta 3 by delta. Now what is delta 1? Delta 1 is the element, so this is 1, 2 and 3. And suppose this is a point P. Right. So now L1 is delta 1 by delta, L1 is equal to delta 1 by delta, delta is the area of the whole triangle 1, 2, 3, delta 1 is area of P 2, 3, so area of P 2, 3 divided by area of 1, 2, 3 is L1. Right. So that is what is, so area of the triangle formed by P 2 3 is delta 1, delta 2 is area of P 3 1. Again, see here it is P 3 1, because it is not written as P 1 3, because then the area will become negative. Generally when you calculate the area, you have to always take the the three nodes in anticlockwise fashion, right? Similarly, delta 3
area of triangle P12.
What is the property? Delta 1 plus delta 2 plus delta 3 is equal to delta. Is it not obvious? Because L1 will be function of this, this divided by total. L2 will be this area divided by total. L3 will be 1, 2, P divided by total. So, addition of all these L1, L2, L3 will be delta 1 plus delta 2 plus delta 3 by delta, which will be 1, right. So, that is why this is 1. And in fact, for linear triangular elements, we had again seen this expression many times now, is it not? N1 is this for linear triangular element. Now, if you take 2 here, 1 upon 2 times this, this is the nothing but the area of the triangle P23. P is x and y. P is x and y. 23. P23, area of P23. P is x comma y. P23 is nothing but this half of that determinant. Is it not? So will be this, right? So, if you take this 2 inside, this is nothing but the area of triangle subtended by P, which is xy, and 2, 3. And then that is, you know, that is why it is delta P23 divided by delta. So, it is L1. So, that is why for linear triangular element, L1 is equal to N1. So, that means we need not, at that time when we saw the procedure, we need not have inverted that 3 by 3 matrix to eliminate ABC. We could have directly used this property and got that. But since we had not seen that this general theory of natural coordinates, we did not use it there, and I wanted you to understand general procedure of FEM. So, that is why we went by inversion there. But here, we can directly get N1 by just calculating, you know, this is the ratio of 2 triangular areas, is it not? So, similarly, you will have N2 and N3. So, that is why for linear triangular element, we know NIXY, that means any N either at 1, 2 or 3 will be given by this AI1 plus AI2 L2 plus AI3 L3, right. So, for I equal to 1, that is node 1, A11 will be 1 because N1 is equal to L1, is it not? I is equal to 2. N2 will be equal to L2. So, that is why this should be 1, this 2 should be 0, right. Similarly, for N3. So, for linear triangular element, then you are, so this is a generalized expression for any Ni. So, Ni will be in general function of L1, L2, L3, right. But for linear triangular element, N1 is equal to L1, N2 is equal to only L2. And N3 will be equal to only L3. So, correspondingly those coefficients will have values, okay. Now, having understood this, for quadratic element, we will just extend. Earlier Ni was function of only these 3 terms, is it not? Now, it is a quadratic element. So, you need to have 6 coefficients. So, that is why now Ai4, Ai5, Ai6. And now, instead of here it was only L1, L2, L3. So, what natural to have L1, L2, L2, L3 and L1, L3. So, now Ni is function of not only L1, L2, L3 as linear function, but also their products, okay. Now, what are the unknowns here? All these coefficients, Ai1, Ai2, Ai3 like that. These are all unknowns. And remember, this is at every node, there are 6 unknowns, because this is I equal to 1. So, for node number 1, there will be A1 to A6. For node number 2, there will be A1 to A6. And those you have to evaluate. At node 1, this we have already seen. At node 1, L1 is 1, L2 and L3 are 0. Similarly, these 2. At node 4, L1 and L2 is 0.5, L3 is 0. Is it not? Because see here L2 L2 at node 4. What we are calculating is, this is marked L2, we are calculating at node 4. So, L2 at node 4 means this will be
delta 4.
1, 3, is it not? And divided by the whole area. So, this area is half of this whole area. So, that is why it is 0.5, right? Similarly, you can calculate all the rest of the coefficients. So, now what we have calculated, these are the values of L1, L2, L3 at all the nodes we have calculated. Now, we will use this in calculating those 6 coefficients for every node, because for every node we have to determine these 6 coefficients, right. So, we need 6 equations or 6 conditions. N1 is equal to 1 at node number 1. And it is 0 at all other nodes, is it not? So, that is why N1 is 0 at all the remaining 5 nodes, N1 is 1 only at node number 1. So, what we do is, now we substitute in this expression, N1 is 1 at node number 1, we will substitute N1 at node number 1's coordinates. And at that coordinates, we know what are the values of this L1, L2, L3. We know those because we have evaluated those here. So, L1, L2, L3 we know at every node, is it not? So, we can simply substitute in this expression. So, for example, N1 is N1 at node 1 is 1, right? So, here at node 1 only L1 is non-zero and that is 1. All L2 and L3 are 0. So, all these terms will go down to 0, is it not? Because L2, L3, either L2 or L3 is there in all these remaining 5 terms except this first term, okay. So, that is why you will get 1 as A11 into 1, rest everything will be 0. So, you get A11 is equal to 1. Similarly, you know this for the other 2. You will get A12 and A13 at 0, right. Then let us take one of these examples. Now, at node 4, we know at node 4 N1 is 0 by definition of shape function and property of shape function. Now, at node 4, we have to substitute all these values of L1 to L3. So, at node 4, L1 and L2 is 0.5, L3 is 0. So, L1 and L2 is 0.5. And L3 is 0. So, that is why here 0.5 and 0.5 comes, and then you know here it is L3 is 0, here it is L1, L2, L1, L2 at node number 4 is 0.5, 0.5 and rest again is 0. So, again you know you get the simple expression, and now A1 is known, already calculated. So, A12 and this is also known. So, A14 becomes minus 2. Likewise, you know, you get the remaining 2 terms also, 2 coefficients. So, now by substituting the values of all this A1i to A1ai6 for N1 in this equation 4, now we know all these ai's for node 1. So, then we get L1 minus 2 L1 L2 minus 2 L1 L3. So, after some simplification, you get, and substituting L2 plus L3 as 1 minus L1, because L1 plus L2 plus L3 is 1. So, then finally, you get N1 as this, right. So, just see the difference. For linear element, N1 was just equal to L1, but for quadratic element, N1 is L1 times twice L1 minus 1, right. So, now, we can likewise, we can obtain expressions for other shape functions, right. So, N1 say then, so all these Ni's for 1, 2, 3 will be this, will get similar, and N4, N5, N6 you will get like this, 4 L1, L2, 4 L2, L3, 4 L1, L3. This you can verify by the same procedure that was explained earlier. Right. So, now we go further. Now, we suppose we want to solve this Poisson's equation in magnetostatics. del square A equal to minus mu j. And then as we have discussed earlier, j should not be associated with, mu should not be associated with j, because mu can vary in the geometry. So we bring mu on the other side, associate it with del square, right? So that when we integrate, depending upon which element we are in, corresponding mu we will take for that element, right? So now this is Cij, this expression also we have seen earlier, is it not? This is nothing but del ni dot del nj, right? That expression is this. So the element coefficient matrix is will be 6 by 6 matrix with this corresponding expression as this. And then the bi, the right hand side matrix, which is source, again you will get j integrated over that element area ni ds, right? Now we will see later, to be proved in a later slide, we will see that here earlier we, when it was a linear element, we, what did we do? We apportioned j equally to the 3 nodes as j delta by 3, is it not? Here also we will get that, but that j gets apportioned equally to not the, you know, 1 to 3, but to the middle nodes. So bi is equal to j delta by 3 for nodes 4, 5 and 6, and it is 0 for nodes 1, 2, 3. Why? We will see later. So now CE is a symmetric matrix given by Cije, this, that means this is an element level matrix now, right? And this will be 6 by 6 matrix, is it not? This will be 6 by 6 matrix. So the, you know, Cij in general is given by this expression. Now C11 is this, which is same as earlier. Now this C11 for linear triangular element also was identical, this was the same. But C12 is different. C12, that means off diagonal elements are different. So C12 is this, C15 is 0, because again C15, C26 and C34 are 0. Why? Because there is no connection. Remember, 1, 5, 2, 6 and 3, 4, there is no connection, is it not? So then how do we get this? Now here I have given one book reference. This book is basically finite element method in electromagnetics. This is for high frequency electromagnetics mostly, but if you want to verify the, you know, these coefficients, values and expressions, you can, you know, refer this book. And some of these, you know, coefficients have already been derived, which we will see in the next lecture. So, you know, all this, don't get worried about these expressions, because this is one time effort, is it not? If you do coding and these, all these coefficients are known, PIs and QIs. So now we will see derivation of some of these coefficients that we have seen in the previous slide. For example, this we know now Cij is this. So C11 will be simply I and j replaced by 1, 1. So this is, this will be the C11, right? Now N1 we have derived, N1 is L1 times twice L1 minus 1, right? And what is L1? It is the area of two point P, 2, 3 divided by the total area, right? So that is L1. And we had already seen that Li expression is this. Li expression is this. For example, L1 is, here it will be A1, P1, Q1, and then P1 and Q1 as usual, these are the our expressions. These we have seen number of times, is it not? So if you substitute further, capital N1 is twice L1 square minus L1. So now L1 is this bracketed term square minus 1 upon 2 delta again L1, right? So in equation 1, the term daba n 1 by daba x is evaluated by taking the first derivative of equation 5, right? So we have to just take daba, when you are talking of first derivative, you just take a derivative of this, and then you will get this expression by delta square. So this whole thing is d by dx of this. The minus derivative of this term with respect to x will be simply P1 upon 2 delta. right? And then now you can resubstitute this, because this is nothing but twice delta L1, because L1 is this. So since we are getting the same terms, we can resubstitute those terms and we get this, and finally we get this simplified expression, right. So then del daba n1 by daba x into daba n1 by daba x is equal to the product of these two terms, right, and then you get this. Similarly, you can calculate daba n1 by daba y into daba n1 by daba y. Instead of p1, you will have now q1. That is the only difference. Here they will be all, these are all p1s, because that was, p1 was here multiplied by x. So in derivative you will have p1. When you are taking now with respect to y, only q1s will come. Right. So here you have expressions with only q1, and then you get this as daba n1 by daba y into daba n1 by daba y as this. So now c11 is equal to this total sum of these two terms that we have calculated. So now each of those two terms are having three terms, so that is why you have now six terms. And now we use this integration formula which we have seen earlier, dx dy, integration with respect to dx dy. So again it will be this formula which we have seen earlier. And now actually if you, for each of these terms, if you use this formula everywhere, you will get, for example this is 4 p1 square L1 square, right. So L1 square means m is, L is 2, is it not? And that actually you substitute here, so 2 factorial, and m and n are 0, so 0 factorial, 0 factorial, 0 factorial is 1, so that is why you get only 2 factorial here, and then L is 2, m is 0, so 2 plus 2, 4 factorial, okay. So likewise you can calculate all the terms, by using this formula, and then you simplify, you will get, 4 terms, they get cancelled, and C11 just reduces to this. So I think we will stop here and continue next time.